ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं वादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ शांति शांति शांति। कर्माणि कति विधानि सन्ति इति चेत्, आगामी संचित प्रारब्ध भेदेन त्रिविधानि सन्ति। ओपन योर बुक, द मंत्रा इज देयर। कर्माणि कति विधानि सन्ति, आगामी संचित प्रारब्ध भोगेन त्रिविधानि सन्ति। द मीनिंग इज, if it is asked how many kinds of karmas are there, karmani kati vidhani shanti iti chet, this is the a method to ask a question in Sanskrit. Karmani kati vidhani shanti iti chet, if it is asked how many kinds of karmas are there, the reply is agami sanchita prarabdha vedena, there are three kinds of karma, namely agami, sanchit and prarabdha. This is the today's topic, very important topic, the law of karma. Agami means coming in future. Whatever karma action we are doing right now, their fruits, their results must come. No one can stop, even God, no exception. Whichever work have been done, they must give their results in future. But time is not fixed. No one knows. Only God knows, because fruit is in hand of God. So only God knows which action is going to give their results, when, what time. And no one can escape. In our scriptures are written, avasyameva bhoktavyam kritam karma subhashubham. One has to experience the fruit of deeds which has been done. No one can escape. We are free. We are free to do work. We are free to do action. But we are not free for its results. We are bound. whatever good or bad actions, karmas we do, we have to forcefully to get their results. And another thing is, the process of the action, is it going on continuously? In Srimad Bhagavad Gita, Lord Sri Krishna says, Nahi kaschit shanamapi jatu tishtati akarmakrit. Lord says, Arjun, no one can even for a moment remain really inactive. We have to do work continuously. Very first breathing, we take and work is simultaneously the last breathing. Work is proof you are alive. You are alive. So every time, every moment, we are engaged with work. We are engaged with action. Even a single moment, in deep sleep also, anytime. So action means what? Whatever we do, knowingly, unknowingly, all are actions. Normally we understand that when we do work, go to school, office, factory, reading books, we say that this is the action, this is the work. What our scripture says, no. Work has results in two types. Visible results and invisible results. We think about only visible results. We don't think about invisible results. Every moment we are busy, we are engaged with action. In very first level, the action comes into our mind in form of thought. Thought is the seed of all actions. So thought is also action. So every moment, every time we are engaged, thought may be good, thought may be bad. These actions are invisible for others. But you can see your thought, you can see your actions. So in this level, thought is continuously in our mind. And good thought is beneficial to us. Bad thought, very harmful to us. Good thought may be beneficial for others also. Because thought is very strong. So, if we have good thought, it is very beneficial to us also. This is the first level of action. That is why our rishis used to think, Sarve bhavantu sukhina, सर्वे सन्तु निरामया सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःख भाग् भवेत्। सो दिस इज थॉट लेवल बट वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग एक्शन सीड ऑफ ऑल एक्शंस। सो दिस इज थ्री लेवल्स। नाउ आई एक्सप्लेन एक्शन बाय माइंड, एक्शन बाय स्पीच एंड एक्शन बाय बॉडी। देर आर थ्री लेवल्स, एक्शन इन माइंड, एक्शन इन स्पीच एंड एक्शन इन द बॉडी। फर्स्ट लेवल इज मेंटल लेवल। थॉट कम्स इन आवर माइंड बिकॉज ऑफ आवर गुणास, आवर नेचर। So sometimes it may be good thoughts, sometimes it may be bad thoughts because of your guna, your nature, sattva rajatam. So if you want for good thought, you have to improve your sattva guna. So this is a mental level. Thoughts are very clear for you, but not for others. And very powerful. Thoughts can change your whole life. This is the seed. And in this level, all our meditations, practice we do in this level. They are also work. We do practice for meditation. The next level is speech. When thoughts continuously coming in our mind, one thought repeatedly coming and going our mind, it becomes more strong. And we want to express it for others also. Because in mental level, your thought you can experience. No other person can see. But now you want to express your thought, your emotion to others, then we take medium of speech. This is the second level, kayik, manasik, kayik, vachik, and manasik. The second level is action of speech. We want to express our thought to others, then we start to speak. You can give respect, you can abuse, you can show your angerness, your greediness, anything. Now your thought, your action, next level, speech level, and if your thought is, your speech is good, then it give good result. If your speech is not good, it gives bad results. By speech, we do japa for good, Lord's name, chanting, study. These everything are all are action. It is by speech. This class also like speech. So this is second level. We have done mental level, then speech level. Third one is, this is the gross level of the action in body. This is the last one. We want to express our thought in more grossify than we take support from the body. In this level, not even human being, even animals, birds can express their emotions, their thought, their anger, their greediness. In a speech level, human beings have the capacity to express their thought. No other animals, they can try. You try to understand their language. Even words, they don't have the capacity to express their thought in speech level. But in this level, in gross body level, every living beings can express their thought. You can see the dog is angry. You can see the dog is in love. You can see the words, their thoughts now you can see in body level. Very gross level. So these are three levels, manasik, vachik, and kayik. Mental level, speech level, and body level. But remember one thing, every action is not going to give you fruit. We are doing so many actions knowingly, unknowingly. They do not going to produce their results, bad and good, because you are not doing intentionally. They are becoming by nature. These actions, animals also doing. Same way, we are also doing, but without intention. Just work is going. You are sleeping, work is going. There are so many actions. They are not going to give you any result, good or bad. Now the question is, what kind actions give us fruit? Scriptures say, when you work with doership. Remember, when you do work with doership, I am the doer. I am the doer. When doership comes in our mind, then our actions is going to give us their fruits. So doer is the main reason. Action start producing the results in form of good or bad. Then we are eligible take its fruit. So doership is the most important point. You and between you and work. Every work is not going to give its fruit to you. When doership enters, then everything comes. A self-realized person, when do a work, he do not have any doership. Lord Sri Krishna, that is why in Gita says, यस्य अनाहंकृतो भावो बुद्धिर्यस्य न लिप्यते. Who has no intention, no doership? Who has no doership with any work, any action? He will not going to experience any good or bad results. Now the question is, action has been done. But who is the doer? Consciousness is not doer. So identified limited soul, we can say Jivatma is the doer. So doership comes, then the fruits, results, good or bad, we have to experience. And karma, action, gives two types fruit, two types result. Some results are visible and some are not visible. Some are visible. You can see, you work for a company. After 1 month, end of the month, you get salary. It's a visible. Visible, scriptures does not interfere in visible results. Do not interfere scriptures. These are visible results. But our tendency is, we follow the law of action, we believe the law of action, but not in full. We believe in half. Everyone believe law of action, law of karma, everyone believe. That is why we have created so many quotations, work is worship. So everyone believes, but they believe only half, only visible. Scripture says no, this is not whole process. Work means what? The procedure is work, then its result. Now procedure is completed. You did job for a company, this is a half day. And after the month, we will get a salary. This is a whole process. Same, the procedure is action and its result. So we believe half work and visible result. Scripture says, no, there are some work and its result. In future. Here, in Tattvabodha, karmani katividhani santi itihi. This matter, the law of action, the law of karma, scriptures say very central point. Not only aspect of the Vedanta. This is a very central point. The whole spirituality. The whole spirituality is based on that point. If you do not believe the law of action, then no need, no spirituality, no religion, no morality, nothing. Scripture says, कर्माणि कति विधानि, हाउ मेनी टाइप्स आर एक्शंस कर्मास। तत्वबोधा सेज देयर आर थ्री काइंड्स ऑफ एक्शन, वन इज आगामी, देन संचित एंड प्रारब्ध। त्रिविधानी शंति, दीज आर थ्री टाइप्स। आगामी, प्रारब्ध एंड संचित। टेक एग्जाम्पल टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस टॉपिक, नॉट स्टोरी, जस्ट एग्जाम्पल। सपोज समवन हैज 100 मिलियन डॉलर, अ मनी ऑफ 100 मिलियन डॉलर, ही द ओनर। सो 100 मिलियन डॉलर ही मे इन्वेस्ट समवेयर इन द बैंक्स, बैंक अकाउंट्स, सो दिस इज संचित, डिपोजिटेड इन द अकाउंट्स, अक्यूमुलेटेड। 100 मिलियन डॉलर ही मे इन्वेस्टेड समवेयर इन द बैंक अकाउंट्स, इन द सेल्फ, वेयर एवर। ही इज द मास्टर, ही इज द ओनर 400 मिलियन डॉलर्स। दिस इज संचित एंड ही इज डूइंग जॉब आल्सो, ही हैज 100 मिलियन डॉलर बट स्टिल ही इज डूइंग जॉब। सो एवरी मंथ ही गेट्स सम सैलरी, ही गेट्स सम सैलरी। This salary is like agami. He is earning money. We are doing it right now. So this is agami. So after end of the month, he will get salary. This is not sanchit. This is not his account. This is a separate money he is earning now. So we can say this is agami. Third one is, we have 100 million dollar, but we make a plan. Made a plan to expense the money, or weekly, or monthly. Every week, we need so much money for expenses. So we collect. We take money from our account. We collect the money. $100, $200, $1,000, whatever, according to requirement. So when we take money, $100, $200, $1,000, $2,000, whatever. So from our account, we take money for daily maintenance, daily expenses. So this is prarabdha. So you have money, three types, sanchit in your account, agami, you will get salary because you are doing job, and you take money from your account, 100, 200, whatever. So this is the prarabdha. Here, go ahead. Jnana utpatti anantaram jnani deha kritam punya papa rupam karma yadasti tad agami iti avidhiyate. I repeat again, jnana utpatti anantaram ज्ञान उत्पत्ति अनंतरम, डॉन ऑफ नॉलेज, ज्ञान उत्पत्ति अनंतरम ज्ञानी देह कृतम, पुण्य पाप रूपम कर्म यदस्ति तद आगामी इति उच्च अभिधीयते। व्हाट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द आगामी? हियर इज रिटन आगामी, समवेयर वी कॉल इट क्रियमाण, क्रियमाण वी आर डूइंग राइट नाउ। See the translation. Gyan utpatya nantaram gyani deha kritam. The result of actions, good or bad, performed through the body of the gyani after the dawn of knowledge has known is agami. I repeat the translation. ज्ञान उत्पत्ति अनंतरम ज्ञानी देह कृतम पुण्य पाप रूपम, द रिजल्ट्स ऑफ द एक्शन गुड आर बैड परफॉर्म्ड थ्रू द बॉडी ऑफ ज्ञानी आफ्टर द डॉन ऑफ नॉलेज इज नोन एज आगामी। आगामी मीन्स क्रियमाण, वी आर डूइंग राइट नाउ। So this definition for everyone, not only for Jnani. Kriyaman. So this action will give results in future. Sanchitam kim? The question, what is Sanchit Karma? What is Sanchit Karma? You open your the book. Sanchit karma. What is sanchit karma? The answer is ananta koti janmanam bija bhutam sat yat karma jatam purva arjitam tishtati tat sanchitam geyam. Sanchitam geyam. The results of action performed in the previous births, which are the seed form to give rise to endless crores of births in future, is called sanchita, accumulated karma. I repeat, what is sanchit? Here is written, अनंत कोटि जन्म नाम बीज भूतम ईसत यत कर्म जातम पूर्व अर्जितम। द रिजल्ट्स ऑफ एक्शन परफॉर्म्ड इन ऑल प्रीवियस बर्थ्स व्हिच आर इन द सीड फॉर्म टू गिव राइज टू एंडलेस करोर्स ऑफ बर्थ्स इन फ्यूचर इज कॉल्ड संचिता accumulated karma. The next one also, prarabdham karma kim iti chet. The next question is, if it is asked, this I told you is a method of question answer in Sanskrit. Prarabdham karma kim iti chet. This is a simple method. If it is questioned, what is prarabdha karma? So meaning, the definition is, idam shariram utpadya iya loke evam sukha dukhadi pradam yat karma tat prarabdham bhogena nashtam bhavati prarabdha karmanam bhoga devakshayam itihi. The definition is, idam shariram utpadya, having given birth to this body, idam shariram utpadya, having given birth to this body, the action which give results in this very world in the form of happiness or misery, and which can be destroyed only by enjoying or suffering them, is called prarabdha karma. the one more time its translation. Idam sariram utpadya, having given birth to this body, the actions which give results in this very world in the form of happiness or misery, and which can be destroyed only by enjoying or suffering them, is called prarabdha karma. So three types of karma. As I gave you example, your bank account, bank balance, like a Sanchit. Your salary is like Agami. And your daily expenses, it's Prarabdha. So this is the law of action, law of karma. Agami, they must come. No one can avoid it. If we accept totally the law of karma, we accept but in half way, according to our convenient. This is our tendency. We do japa, we do anything according to our principle. We are not ready to follow scriptures. We follow scriptures according to our convenience. Truth is truth. We cannot change. We should follow truth according to this way, not our way. Scripture says, any action, any karma, give you visual result. This is the worldly result. I told you, scripture says this is not our matter. You decide. It's your job. You decide what kind job do you want to do. But we have to understand, we have to believe the whole process of action. There are visible results and invisible results also. Invisible. If we believe in visible, there are so many benefits. I give you some points to you here. If we believe the full process of law of action, so there are so many questions in our mind. These questions automatically will be solved. The first question, we cannot understand the differences between beings are human beings. There are so many disparity. There are so many human beings. They are rich by birth. By birth. Because their family is rich. There are so many people who takes birth in slums. So this difference, there are so many peoples blind by birth. There are so many people, they have so many diseases by birth. There are so many people die after some time. And there are so many other people they are poor. By birth, they take birth in beggar's house. So by birth, a person is very rich. Millions of millions of dollars he achieved by birth. And other person is in slum, in beggar's house, he don't have anything. So this difference, without doing anything, how is it possible? Some are blind by birth. Some are good health, long life. So these differences, we cannot explain. We cannot explain, but we can just accidentals. But this is not good logic. It's not understandable. If we believe the law of karma, then actually you can understand. You can understand. These all things are because of their past lives. Because of their past lives results. One thing, if we believe the law of karma completely, I'm not telling halfway. Halfway belief. Everyone believes in visible results. Scripture says not only visible results, but invisible results also. The next thing will come, your responsibilities. You will be responsible. If we believe in this law, it means whatever we have in this life, so this is because of our past life's karma. Because of past life's karma, whatever we have. There are so many people, they are trying their best. They are more intelligent. But they do not have so much things. So everything is not because of your work in this life. So very easily, if we believe that in this law, we can understand we are the responsible for this life, whatever we have, we did in past lives. And we are responsible, we would be responsible for our future. Whatever we do, its result will come in future. So we are responsible. You will be responsible if you believe in this law. One more point. Sometimes we have lots of questions. There are so many persons, like self-realized persons. You have been heard. The great saints had cancer. Ramakrishna Paramahansa had Krishna cancer. Ramtirtha had cancer. Then question comes to mind. They were great. They did not do any wrong in this life. They were pure. What then, why? What the cause for their illness? Their life is so pure. We cannot see any such a thing who can give him such big disease. but they had a big disease. And some other person, they had everything in bad habits, they are fit. So then my question comes in our mind, how is it possible a great personality, a great self-realized person has cancer? If you believe in this law, you can understand it very easily. This law says any person, even self-realized person also, he will experience their past life's action. If he did bad, he had to experience. He cannot escape. Here, in this last mantra, written by Shankaracharya, Prarabdha Bhoga Deva Kshayam. The Prarabdha, I called you for daily expenses. So body is made by daily expenses. So even Brahma Jnani, self-realized person, enlightened person also have to experience their bad deeds. No one can escape. Always remember, no one can escape. One more question, how many times you ask? Sometimes I am in big problems. Someone is in big problems. He is very good person, very religious person, but in big problems. There is so many times he asks, what is the problem? I am not doing anything wrong. I have not done anything wrong for others. Then why am I so suffering? Only answer is law of action. One more point. If you believe in this process, then you must have believe in God. And justice of God. Sometimes we complain to God. Oh God, why do you do for me such misery, such sadness? I am a good person. We do not believe a judging power in God. We see injustice of God with us. But you believe, we accept this law, you can understand, yes, God is there. Because we did work, we have done work and died. So after that, who will give the results of the actions? So there must be something like God who give us, who know everything about us. He was before birth, he will be after death. Every time he knows everything. So law of action, if we accept completely, so many problems automatically will be solved. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam केशवं वादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ओम शांति शांति शांति।